Okay, so now I am at our pumpkin field at Faculty of Botany and Nursery. This is called Faculty of Sustainable Agriculture, University of Malaysia, Sabah and Sandakan campus. So this is our pumpkin field. So as our farm staff, they have planted some pumpkin plants here. So today I wanted to show you or wanted to make it clear about the male and female flowers of pumpkin. So pumpkin, that is cucurbit, huh? Is from the cucurbitaceae family. So another name is the sweet gourd. We also call it the gourd family. So pumpkin actually is a monoecious plant. Monoecious plant. Hopefully you have everyone you have the idea. The pumpkin, the cucurbits, that means the sweet gourd, is a monoecious plant. Meaning is that male and female flower in the same plant but in different location, that means in different position of the plants, and they have the male flower different, female flower also different. So today I want to show you very clearly how we can differentiate them, the male flower and the female flower. So today at morning is around here about 9:30 now. So usually the pumpkin, they start producing the flower at the early morning and is active until about 10, 11, something like that. So here I have found one of male flower. So firstly, I want to show you or introduce with the male flower first. So you can see this is a male flower. So male flower is always without the ovary. There is no ovary, only the petioles, the long petioles. And this is the male inside. Inside they have only the anther. So the anther is carrying huge pollen here. So it's usually the yellow color. So I am showing you this is all are the anther, the yellow anther. So this is a little bit moist. They say the morning there is the precipitation at the night. So for this, so this is a male flower. So you can see this is inside that there are the anther carrying the pollen, huge number of pollens. So this is a male flower. Later I will try to differentiate it very clearly, the male and female. So now here I have found one female flower very far from here, but I will try to show the female flower. Usually in the monoecious plant, and depending on the different types of variety, the number of male flower is very high compared to female. So you can see here is a very giant pumpkin. You can see very giant pumpkin that is going to is very very it is very new and very tendril, not mature yet. So when it mature, it will be very big, I hope. Okay, so here you can see all are male flower, so many male flower. So sometimes there have some of the problems. So when the plant gets a stress or nutrient deficiency, so that time usually they grow huge number of male compared to female. So this is also male flower. So now I want to show you a female flower. You can see this one is the female. So this is the ovary. So from the ovary, because female, they produce or they born with the ovary. So by this way, we can very clearly we can differentiate them. So the ovary is here. So and the here of the is called the stigma. This is stigma. You see the several fold here equal to six folded. So this is stigma here inside. You can see this also yellow color, and it's supposed to be very sticky. So and here for the pollination, so have to help by honeybee or some other flies. Sometimes there are so many ants inside also. You can see there are so many ants inside, so they are helping. So they're carrying the pollen from the male flower and carrying here. So in that plant, this another female flower you can see. So but unfortunately this plant by now there is no male. So but side this just opposite that one there is a male here. So there's so many butterfly also I'm flying here, you can see. So there is the back side is another plant, this carrying the male. So by that way, so they can get the pollen by any means, whether by flies, whether by honeybees, whether by any other types of insects. So they will help in the pollination. So you can see several female here. So this is one female, this is another female, this is another female, So these characteristics of that plant, maybe this plant is producing huge number of female compared to male, but some other plants, they are mostly producing huge number of male. So this beside another plant, so the same plant, you can see this is the male and already produced the pumpkin here. So this is the this is in one branch, this one branch, this is the female, that is the already produced the cucurbits, that means the pumpkin, and there is the male flower. So this is the, by this way we can easily differentiate that which one is the male and which one is the female by the ovary and the monoecious, that means the same plant, they will produce male and female. So here another plant, they're producing another female here. So later in my office, so I will show you very clearly the male and female, how we can differentiate them.
Okay, so now I'm already in my field and my office, that I have already shown you about the whole field in the on the field level, the cucurbits, the pumpkin, how they are looks like the male female flower with the fruit, some of them. So I have already in my office to show you the different parts of the male and female flower, so how they are looks like. So you can see I have already dissected the male and female. So this is the male flower, and I have already dissected the corolla, the petals. So this is the corolla, five petals. So I have already dissected. So they have five sepals. So one sepals is already dissected with the petals. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you can see the male flower is with only the, this is called the what is called the petioles. So no symptoms of ovary here. So easily we can differentiate by this identification characteristics that this is the male, and male is with the anther. This is the top. So this is the top is with the anthers. The anther is calling huge numbers of, we can say the 100,000 millions of pollens here. So they are also sticky, because if they are not sticky, so they cannot attach with the legs of the insect, honeybees or other butterflies or whatever insects. So this huge number of the whole surrounding all the anther, there is a huge number of pollens. So this is the male flower, and this is the female. So you can see this is the female. So female is always with the ovary. From the ovary we can easily differentiate, we can easily identify this one is female with the symbol of carrying the ovary, they born with the ovary. So easily we can differentiate male, this is female. So female with the stigma at the top, this is looks like a calf like, and this is also yellowish color and also very sticky. So they have to catch the pollen as well, so they are very sticky at the period they are in anthesis period, because they are ready to receive the pollen. So when the anthesis period is over, then they become dry, they cannot catch the pollen anymore. Okay, so how they are doing the pollination? So there is two types of pollination here, do the self pollination and the cross pollination. Self pollination meaning is that when they are receiving the pollen from the same plant, this is called the self pollination. But when any female flower, the stigma, they are carrying the receiving the pollen from another plant but similar types, otherwise they are not compatible. So the pollen from another plant, this is called the cross pollination. But as our research purpose or the seed production purpose, we have to do the control self pollination or control cross pollination. How is looks like that? Before opening the female, suppose the cucurbits, majority of the cucurbits, they usually bloom at early morning. Some of them are the variation, but most of them very early morning they open, and they usually active until 9, 10, 11 something at the time. So the flower supposed to open tomorrow morning before on day, that means early of the, that means the evening time or afternoon time, we have to bag the flower, the female flower we have to bag. Then in the next morning, if it is the self pollination, then we have to collect the male flower from the same plant, and we have to open the bag. After opening the bag, we have to help by this way. We can remove the petals or cannot. Sometimes this is for making it easier, so better to remove the corolla, the petals. Then we have to do like this. This is, you can see they are carrying the pollen. So they are sticky, so they easily they can carry the pollen. So this is the self pollination if the flower from the same plant. So this is the maintenance of the variety, the inbred lines. If you want to maintain the parental line seed, then you have to do the self pollination or some other issues. I am not going to that. And if you want to develop a new variety, hybrid variety, then we have to collect the anther, the male flower from the selected male parent. Then after collecting, the same thing, we have to bag it. Then up the morning, we have to collect the male flower, the selected male parent. Then we have to do the same thing, the pollination, the cross pollination, as the male is different plant from the different cross pollination. So after that, we have to bag it again, because we don't know about the successfulness of the pollination. The successful, that means after successful fertilization, the ovary will start to be vigor. That means when they are successful, then the ovary will be vigor slowly, and the corolla, the petals will be dried, and the ovary will be bigger in size. That means they are successful and producing the fruits. So after that, we can remove the bags, and we have to maintain the tag as well for the identification. So this is all about the self pollination and cross pollination. And in cucurbits, the pumpkin, so male flower, this is female flower, male with the anther, at the anther carrying the pollen, female with the ovary, and the top they are carrying the stigma. And this is the, whether it is self pollination from the same plant, it is for the, if the male from other, this is cross pollination. So by this way, you have to maintain the, either the inbred lines or the hybrid line, the new F1 seed. So this is all about the cross pollination, self pollination, and identification of monoecious crops, the cucurbits, the pumpkin, from the field of Faculty of Sustainable Agriculture, University of Malaysia Sabah, the Sandakan campus. So hopefully it will be helpful, especially for the students, for the undergraduate students, and obviously those who are doing the master's or PhD in monoecious, any types of monoecious crops, because the characteristics is mostly similar. So there is other types, especially the papaya. Papaya is also monoecious, dioecious, hermaphrodite, all together. But as I have tried to show here, the cucurbit, the pumpkin, so it will be very easier and helpful. So hopefully I will come up with another video with another crops that will be much more easier to understand and to do the self and cross pollination of that crops. So that's all from me. Thank you so much.